सो हेलो एंड वेलकम फ्रेंड्स टू अवर चैनल इंट्रोमैक एंड वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट मेटल फॉर्मिंग प्रोसेसेस एंड प्रीवियसली वी हैव कवर्ड द रोलिंग प्रोसेस देन वायर ड्रॉइंग प्रोसेस एंड एक्सट्रूजन प्रोसेस. सो नाउ वी विल लुक फॉर द फोर्जिंग प्रोसेस. वॉट इज फोर्जिंग एंड वॉट इज इट्स मेन एडवांटेज. नाउ वी हैव सीन थ्री डिफरेंट फॉर्मिंग processes. Okay, so as we have seen in case of say first rolling operation, so we have rollers and we are passing the material from the roller and it is coming out of the roller. Now this material has a uniform cross section. Now again we have wire drawing process in which we have a die and through which we pass the material and we get the material out of the die. Then we seen the extrusion process like in which there is a die and it has an opening and the material is pushed with the help of a ram. So again the material is coming out of the die. Now in this all processes if we see, we are getting uniform cross section of the material. We cannot vary the cross section of the material which we are getting. The section can be here, like we can get this shape like square, circular, whatever according to the shape of the die, but the section is uniform throughout its length. We cannot vary this section. So this is the main limitation of all these processes. So now in case of forging, we can get a non-uniform cross-sectional area to some extent. So this is one of the advantage. So with the help of forging, we can produce the components which are having different cross-sectional area, and that's how we can apart, we can give them the properties, different properties in different directions, and we can achieve our target. So let's focus on the forging process. So as I have shown here, in forging process there are two dies, like a top die, say this is a top die, this is my top die which is moving, and this is my bottom die which is a stationary die. Okay, and I have kept my material in between these two dies. So when we apply the pressure or force on this material will bulge out and we will get a deformed shape. Okay, so let's consider the deformed shape, like this is the second condition, the die has come downward. So what will happen, this material will bulge out, right? So if initially my material, say it is having diameter DO, say original diameter, then what will happen, it will bulge out and this will be my DF. So this was my DO and this is my DF. On the same thing, I have initial H, say I, like this, and now my height has reduced, which is my final height. So by applying the compressive load on this material, we will get the final dimensions like DF and HF. I have considered it as a circular cross section, so that's why I have written here DO and DF. Now the material volume is same, the shape has changed, so the initial volume, I can write it as initial volume and final volume will be same. So if we write like this, then we can write as the volume, that is the initial area into say my HI will be equal to my final area into say my HF. Sorry, so this is my final height. Okay, so how we can find out this final height is you can just put out the put out the values here of area, and finally we can write HF as DO by my DF square into H say I initial. Okay, so this will be my final height which I will get after the forging operation. So this is how the forging operation is carried out. Now let's go into some details. So let's do the analysis. Now how the material flow. So let's draw the operation. Okay, so here I have my top die, right, and here I have my bottom die, as we have seen. Now my the material is in between here. When I'm applying force, what is happening, this material is bulging like this. Okay, so if we see here, it is bulging like this. Now what is happening here? So when I'm applying the load, this material here, it is in contact with the die, and again the material here is in contact with the die surface here. So there is a friction acting between these two surfaces here and the two surfaces here. Now this friction force try to oppose the motion of this material. It try to go outward, but the frictional force is acting like inward. Okay, here and here, because there is a wall and there is a die material and there is the material which I am forging. So because of the friction here and here, we have a friction coefficient, and because of this friction, the material is the material is not uniformly bulging. It is taking a shape like this. Now in the initial phase, this frictional force is greater than the applied force on the body. So because of that, what will happen, the material try to stick to the die. So the initial process can be analyzed with the help of sliding friction model, because there is a sliding motion, there is a sliding of the material, so let's analyze the forging operation. Now here we can see that we have a die from the top and bottom and the material here. Now when I apply the force in the downward direction, actually, so this die will move downward, sorry, and this material will try to take a shape like this. Now as we can see here, the material here is in contact with the die, and also here it is in contact with the die. The die material and this material are having a friction, so there is a frictional coefficient, and the material here trying to expand outward. So there is a outward expansion force which is acting, and at the same time this die and this material surface here have a frictional force which is acting inward. So these forces are like acting in an opposite direction. So initially what happens is this frictional force we can say like say FF is greater than the outward expansion force. Expansion force. So this is like initial condition. So initially this frictional force is greater than the outward expansion force, because of which the material is taking a shape like this. Now this shape resembles to a barrel, so that's why this is called as a barreling region, or it is called as barreling operation. Now in this initial condition, the material is trying to stick to the die, right? Because of the friction, it is trying to stick to the die, and that's why it is also called as a sticking region, or it is analyzed by sticking friction model, because the material is trying to stick to the die. Now eventually, when the force start increasing, what will happen at certain condition, this outward expansion force becomes greater than the frictional force which is acting here, and then the material takes a shape like a cylinder. So now the material has started sliding, and that's why this region is analyzed with the help of sliding friction model. So initially, so if I say this is my first zone, and if this is my second zone, so first zone is analyzed by sticking friction model, and the second one is with sliding friction model. Now we can see here that because of the friction, this material is expanding lesser. At the center, it is free to expand. That's why the expansion is larger. And if we plot the graph of, say, pressure, and this is the distance, like this is if my center, and this is my periphery, and here also my periphery. So this graph we obtain is like at the center I having the maximum pressure, and at the periphery there's a lesser pressure. So this shape looks like a hill, and that's why it is called as a friction hill diagram also. So this is how the material deforms. Now the shape like a cylindrical shape which we obtain from a forging, it's like a thin cylinder, and that's why the process can be analyzed with the thin cylinder having a internal pressure. This pressure is trying to bulge this material like a thin cylinder. That means if we consider a thin cylinder, and if the pressure is like acting inwards, this will try to bulge like this, and it will have a hoop stress and a longitudinal stress. So this forging operation is also considered as a thin cylinder with internal pressure, and it is analyzed on the basis of the same. So this is like my thin cylinder with internal pressure, right? So now let's have some numerical analysis. So as we saw that we can compare the process with thin cylinder. So in thin cylinder there is a hoop stress and there is a longitudinal stress, and the hoop stress is 2 times the longitudinal stress. Similarly, the hoop strain is 2 times of the longitudinal strain. Now the force which is required for this forging operation, how it is calculated? Now this is force, like force, and this actual is the actual force considering all the friction. So it is like yield strength of the material into the final area. This is the coefficient of friction. Now what we have here, let's see. Now sigma y is our yield strength of the material, right? We have AF as the final area which we are getting after the process. Now mu is the coefficient of friction. As we have seen, there is a friction between the die wall and the material, so there is a coefficient of friction. Now RF is the radius of the component or say material after forging, so that is final. We can say radius, F indicates the final, and HF is the final height of the component after the forging operation. Now here I have written as RF because this formula is written by considering the rod is circular. So what if the rod is not circular? So let's say we have some cross-sectional area which is non-circular, so we can just compare it with the circular cross-sectional area, and we know here the area will be pi into RF square. So and this will be the area of our component if it is a square. So there is a side square, or if it is a rectangle, then L into say B. So how we can put the value of RF in terms of these values is like under root of, we will have the cross sectional area divided by pi. So we can calculate the value and we can just put this value over there if the section is say like rectangular or square. So this is not a universal formula, say it is written by considering the circular cross section. Now this is the actual force. So if I consider the ideal conditions, what will be my minimum force which is required? So I have a initial minimum force, so that's why it is as it is initial. So I have considered the original cross-sectional area, so and the final minimum force is like the final area into sigma y. So we are considering the average of these forces because the process is continuous, so that's why the area is changing continuously. So we have to consider the average value, and that's why we have taken the value as average of these two values. So I hope you understood this. So now we have our actual force requirement and the minimum force requirement. So what we can find? Efficiency. So efficiency, all we know is the minimum force requirement divided by the actual requirement, and the efficiency of this process is around 0.4 to 0.5. Now how we can find out the work done, the energy which is spent for carrying out this process, is like my actual force into the displacement, which is like my original height minus the final height. By that much amount I have to displace my die. So force into displacement is nothing but the work done. So this is a simple logic. And if we are continuously pressing the die, then it is called as continuous forging. Then there is another type in which there is a hammer, and the hammer is blown intermittently on the material. So if that is the case, then my work done is 2 times W into H into N. Now here I have W as the weight of my hammer, right, and N are the number of blows, how many number of blows I am giving with the hammer on the material, right? So it indicates the number of blows, and we know the work done, so we can put the value of work done like on this, and from that we can find out this capital H value. So this capital H value is the height from which the hammer is blown, right? So we can find out this value, or either way, if we know all these parameters, we can find out the work done in this process. So these are all the basics of the forging operations, and here we have completed our forming operations. We have covered all the basic forming operations. We have started with rolling process, then we move forward to the wire drawing process, then we see the extrusion process, and we have ended here with our forging operations. So please watch out all the videos so that you can understand all the basic forming operations, and I hope you understood all the processes. And if you have any doubts, please do write into the comment section and we can discuss over there. Until then, be safe and stay happy. Thank you.